a quick guide to confirmation bias. In obstetrics, imagine you are the doctor or midwife working in the maternity assessment unit. A 40-year-old prima gravida presents at 37 weeks gestation with a history of headache and visual disturbance. What is your diagnosis? Your first thought is probably, is this preeclampsia? You therefore recall previous situations and seek information from the patient that confirms your likely diagnosis of preeclampsia. When the patient tells you that she does in fact have a family history of preeclampsia, this evidence further confirms your opinion. You may unconsciously discount that the patient described other symptoms, such as vomiting and fever, which do not fit with your diagnosis. As humans, we are biased towards ourselves, our beliefs, and our values. We do not like feeling uncomfortable, and our brain unconsciously seeks information that confirms our ideas. The brain will ignore, disregard, argue against, or minimise the impact of any evidence to the contrary of our beliefs or ideas. This is called confirmation bias. Bias is when we think in a way which may lead us to be incorrect. So, as humans, we tend to search for, favour, and recall information that confirms our point of view. For example, have you ever discussed about global warming with someone who doesn't believe it to be true, or perhaps had a conversation with someone who believes that the Earth is flat? So why is this important? Well, confirmation bias can prevent us from recognising when we are wrong, or from viewing a problem from a new perspective. When our brain selectively acknowledges information that confirms our impression, we may think in a way which leads us to be incorrect, and therefore cause a patient harm. Let's use our previous example of the same 40-year-old prima gravida presenting at 37 weeks gestation with a headache and visual disturbance. By unconsciously disregarding the patient's symptoms of fever and vomiting, we do not think of the alternative diagnosis, such as meningitis. Instead, confirmation bias has led us to confirm a diagnosis which is probably incorrect and therefore impact the patient's care and safety. So, how can we try to stop confirmation bias? We need to look for the evidence to prove ourselves wrong. Let's take another case as an example. A 38-year-old, para 3, at 36 weeks gestation presents to maternity triage with burning chest pain. She is a smoker with a BMI of 35 and has a history of hiatus hernia. Instead of seeking confirmatory facts to confirm our diagnosis, in this case of acid reflux, we should look for the information that proves our answer wrong. We need to look for evidence of alternative causes. In this case, for example, evidence of pulmonary embolism or cardiac disease. By consciously looking to prove ourselves wrong, we therefore consider the entire clinical picture and can try to make a balanced, fully informed decision, improving patient care and safety.